Welcome to another episode. Today's episode we are going to see whether we are real. This world is a real thing or an illusion. There have been many questions asked in many forums about this. Whether this whole world is something like what happens in the movie Matrix. So let us look into some of the studies which has been done on this aspect. So are we real? So first is some extracts from Daily Galaxy. In 1982, a research team led by physicist Alan Aspect performed one of the most important experiments of 20th century. Aspect and his team discovered that under certain circumstances, subatomic particles such as electrons are able to instantaneously communicate with each other, regardless of the distance separating them. It does not matter whether they are 10 feet or 10 billion miles apart. Somehow each particle always seems to know what other is doing. The problem with this feat is that it violates Einstein's long-held tenet that no communication can travel faster than the speed of light. Since traveling faster than the speed of light is tantamount to breaking the time barrier, this daunting prospect has caused some physicists to try to come up with increasingly elaborate ways to explain away Aspect's findings. University of London physicist David Baum, for example, believes Aspect's findings imply that objective reality does not exist, that despite its apparent solidity, the universe is at the heart of a phantasm, a gigantic and splendidly detailed hologram. Baum was involved in the early development of the holonomic model of the functioning of the brain, a model for human cognition that is drastically different from the conventionally accepted ideas. Baum developed the theory that the brain operates in a manner similar to a hologram, in accordance with quantum mathematical principles and the characteristics of wave patterns. Then let us see the views of Michael Talbot. There is evidence to suggest that our world and everything in it are also only projections from a level of reality so beyond our own, it is literally beyond both space and time. David Baum believed separateness is an illusion. Particles are not individual entities, but are actually extensions of the same fundamental something. He did not believe an objective hard reality exists. Rather, information is enfolded, stored in a quantum base. He used a hologram as a model to explain his theories. Baum considered the universe a giant information headquarters of unbroken wholeness in which everything in the universe is already present in some invisible domain beyond time and space, a field of all possibility to be called forth and made manifest when necessary, a sort of cosmic storehouse of all that is. So let us see Hindu view of this, the illusion of matter. No, this is quantum view of it. The illusion of matter by Arjun Walia. Quantum physicists discovered that physical atoms are made up of vortices of energy that are constantly spinning and vibrating, each one radiating its own unique energy structure, signature. Therefore, if we really want to observe ourselves and find out what we are really beings of energy and vibration, radiating our own unique energy signature. This is fact, and is what quantum physics has shown us time and time again. We are much more than what we perceive ourselves to be. And it's time we begin to see ourselves in that light. If you observed the composition of an atom with a microscope, you would see a small invisible tornado-like vortex with a number of infinitely small energy vortices called the quarks and photons. These are what make up the structure of an atom. As you focused in closer and closer on the structure of the atom, you would see nothing. You would observe a physical void. The atom has no physical structure. We have no physical structure. Physical things really don't have any physical structure. Atoms are made out of invisible energy, not tangible matter. A fundamental conclusion of the new physics also acknowledges that the observer creates the reality. As observers, we are personally involved with the creation of our own reality. Physicists are being forced to admit that the universe is a mental construction. Pioneering physicist Sir James Jeans wrote, "The stream of knowledge is heading toward a non-mechanical reality. The universe begins to look more like a great thought than like a great machine. Mind no longer appears to be an accidental intruder into the realm of matter. We ought rather hail it as the creator and governor of the realm of matter." R.C. This is by R.C. Henry in The Mental Universe, Nature, 436-29-2015. Then now finally we'll see the Maya concept of Hinduism as written by Sangeeta Johari. The one is reality, multiplicity is illusion. This illusion of multiplicity is created by the veiling power of the One, the Supreme Consciousness. This veiling power is called Maya Shakti or Maya. This power creates the illusion of me and the mine, or thee and thine, which creates ignorance in the individual consciousness. Those who realize this ignorance call it avidya. A means no and vidya means knowledge. Thus ignorance or absence of knowledge. So Maya is also called avidya by yogis. This ignorance comes to an individual consciousness through the mind. That is why yoga is the practical device to stop the modifications of mind. And yoga's aim is to arrest mind, to stop the inner dialogue, to go beyond the mind, to realize one's own true nature, beyond the illusions of me and mine. The world of names and forms is Maya. This illusion can be seen at every level. The human body itself is not a unit of existence, but is composed of countless numbers of cells and microcells. If each cell starts growing a sense of me and mine, each human body will become a subcontinent. It is the individual ego, ahamkara, which creates the separate units of existence. But this itself is Maya, or illusion. Ego cannot function without mind, as mind cannot function without sense organs. So it is only after the mind is brought to a suppressed state that the sense of me and mine can be completely annihilated. After realization of truth through a direct experience of reality in samadhi, Maya Shakti can be understood, and the human psychodrama can be observed as a divine play, as Leela. Maya Shakti is the power which brings forth the evolution of the phenomenal world. It makes this possible by an interplay of three gunas, sattva, rajas and tamas. Cosmic consciousness becomes individual consciousness by its own Maya. This diversity in unity is illusion and is caused by the veiling power of the Supreme Consciousness. All that the player perceives of the phenomenal world exists within himself. Two comes into being when one repeats itself. Two is Maya because both are present in the one. The two are internal and the external world, the unmanifested and the manifested, Shiva and Shakti, male and female, sun and moon, gross and subtle, absolute and Maya, noumenon and phenomenon. Two is therefore the number of Maya or illusion, the universal play of cosmic energy. When one accepts entry into the game of life as a player, awareness of unity is lost in the obsession, fascination of play. This taking over of consciousness is the fun of play. The one becomes many to play a game of cosmic hide and seek with itself. Leela is the nature of supreme consciousness, playful nature. The phenomenal world is manifested Leela. The play is beginningless as well as endless. The various levels of this game of life can also be discovered through the ancient Leela game board shown here. No, I don't have. Leela is the great adventure and the great discovery, again and again and again and again, without any loss, without any gain. This endless game is played. Those who realize the play in the game are not caught in the game board and know it as a Leela, divine game of Leeladhar, the Kashmir consciousness. Those who identify with the squares and planes of the game board are played by the game board, and the game board becomes the Maya, illusion. The great veiling power that binds the mind, it is Maya, which creates the phenomenal world. It is Leela that makes it great adventure. Tamas brings the player to Maya and boundless love and spiritual devotion to cosmic consciousness. Spiritual devotion, Bhakti Loka, is great discovery of Leela. Created by Maya of Supreme Consciousness in order to enjoy himself, to play hide and seek with himself. There is no purpose and no responsibility in Leela. In words of Maharishi Ramana, the ideas of purpose and responsibility are purely social in nature and are created by mind to exalt ego. God is above all such ideas. If God is immanent in all, there is no one except him who is responsible for whom. Creation is the expression of inherent laws in the source of creation. This inherent law is the playful nature of divine, which is Leela. So with this understanding, we will end this episode. Please stay with me for further episodes. Subscribe to my channel. Thank you.